since the Bulandshahr mob violence, where Senior Inspector Subodh Kumar Singh was assaulted and shot dead. And today, his family still awaits justice. The Uttar Pradesh government and the police have failed to make any major headway in the case. Till now, 4 people have been arrested for cow slaughter and 10 accused arrested on murder charges. This out of 87 names in the FIR.
Very shameful for the UP police and the entire machinery of UP to see all these accused time and again coming out in media and giving and releasing statement in their defense.
The main accused in the case, Yogesh Raj, continues to abscond. Now, a non-bailable warrant has been issued against the Bajrang Dal member and 26 others who have been accused in the case.
SIT investigation kar rahi hai aur isme jo bhi abhiyukt namit the jo jail ja chuke unke atirikt jo bhi named the aur kuch isme prakash mein abhi tak aa chuke the 5 un sabhi ke khilaf non-bailable warrant issue kiya gaya hai.
Mirror Now asks, why is the UP police dragging its feet in the Bulandshahr case? Let's debate.
Well, we do realize that a lot of other channels tonight are preoccupied by who's going to become chief minister in 3 different states. That decision is being made by Congress High Command. But frankly, as far as we're concerned, whomsoever becomes chief minister of these 3 states, we'll get to work after that person does take over. In the meantime, here is a story we have to insist as Indians, we do not forget. 10 days ago, a senior police officer was attacked and shot right above his left temple here with his own revolver. It's been 10 days. The UP police has made 14 arrests, but the key accused are still absconding. They've now asked for a non-bailable warrant against these 2 people who have been accused. But the question is, if the individuals were releasing videos on the internet talking about how they're innocent, how is it that the UP police couldn't find them? Remember, this is the same UP police that can arrest someone in half an hour flat for writing something offensive about their chief minister, Yogi Adityanath. The question I want to ask is just simply this. Is the police dragging its feet on these 2 individuals? And if so, why? And more importantly, we want to drive home the point that we will not forget about this case. And so we're not going to let it go cold. And there might be a lot of things going on across the country, but we'll keep the pressure on finding those people who killed Senior Inspector Subodh Kumar Singh. Joining me on the show, Atul Chandra, senior journalist joining us out of Uttar Pradesh, Abdul Hafiz Gandhi, spokesperson for the Samajwadi Party, Chandrapal Singh or CP Singh, former Inspector General of Police, Punjab, I beg your pardon, KK Manan, senior criminal lawyer, Ramakant Gore, advocate for the Supreme Court, Anita Agarwal, spokesperson for the UP BJP. I'm going to start with Mr. Chandra, who's a very senior journalist joining us out of Lucknow. Mr. Chandra, I'm sure you're tracking this case very, very, very closely. 10 days on, and the 2 main accused in what should be the most important case for the Uttar Pradesh police have not been found. Is this normal?
This is not normal, certainly, because here we have a very senior police officer being killed by a mob owing allegiance to the ruling party. And it was done supposedly over alleged cow slaughter. When the police officials themselves in Lucknow said that the meat was planted there 2 days back. Now, what is surprising is that it's been 10 days. The main suspect has posted his video on Facebook. Why is it that the UP police haven't tried to use electronic surveillance to track him down? Why is it that all the senior officers in Bulandshahr were transferred at one go, but if some innocent is killed in Lucknow, the SSP is not touched? So you can see that the police are under some pressure. Why I say it? Because almost about 2 hours, within 2 hours of the incident, an FIR was lodged by the Bulandshahr police. Had it not been done, perhaps it would have been difficult to name the accused for the local police because of the pressure from the government, or that is my assumption, and that is how I feel the government works, because it protects such elements. Why? Because in Hapur you see an almost a repeat of what we saw in Bulandshahr, in the sense that BJP leaders are threatening, abusing a senior cop, and now the party functionaries are demanding an inquiry against him. The manner in which the police have now moved court to seek his arrest, requesting for non-bailable warrant, I think it is not needed. They can very easily track him down. And I suppose that there is a total lack of will, only because the government is not interested in getting these accused arrested. This request for non-bailable warrant will probably provide them an escape route and seek bail from the court before even the police, a reluctant police, I should say, crack down on them.
Well, I want to ask Mr. Sipal Singh this question. Mr. Singh, as the former Inspector General of Police in Punjab, do you agree with what Mr. Atul Chandra says right now, that it shouldn't have taken 10 days for the UP police to round up these two people?
By and large, what he has stated is correct. I agree. But the question is, try to understand. Interesting features are coming out. Interesting points are coming out. The inspector has been shot dead with his service revolver.
Yes.
And the injury on the temple of the inspector should have been easily found to be by the experts, by the ballistics expert, to have been fired from the service revolver. Mm. Now the question is, most of the service revolver have the same bore. Why it was not thought at that time by the police that his service revolver has been used? So if the service revolver is used, as you know, the range of the service revolver is very close. The service revolver, or any revolver for that matter, cannot fire at an individual or cannot kill an individual at a distance of more than about 10 meters. Obviously, that man came very close, 8 to 10 meters. So this is first defect, fault, or I would say very, very lax way of investigation. A police inspector, his service revolver has been fired from a distance of less than about 8 meters. And we are not able to say, and yet, at times, the statements were made that it was accidental death. Some of the senior officers went forward and said this is accidental death. Why did they conclude accidental death? Why should they conclude? Mm. No. When the FIR was to be lodged, the main point and main emphasis all the time on the FIR was the cow slaughter. That FIR was immediately, and some of the leaders went at the police station and asked the concerned IO as to why you have not arrested people who are involved in the cow slaughter. Mind, the cow slaughter are the carcasses of the cow. Maybe it's very important. Maybe there is a law that cow slaughter should not there. But can you, by any stretch of imagination, think that a slaughter of a cow is more important, or slaughtering, killing a police inspector is more important? Why the emphasis were being laid on the fact whether the cow slaughterers have been arrested or not? Three, even after about 7 days, a few days back, the ministers, they gave a statement that this is purely a case of accidental firing, accidental death. I am surprised. I said, what are you trying to impress on the police? Obviously, the police will get a clue that the higher-ups do not want us to go seriously into investigation. So I am of the firm view that in this case particularly, the IO and his officers have miserably failed. It's a dismal state of affair that a police inspector has been killed who is an insignia, I told last time, of the legal processes of law. All the criminal procedure code revolves around the inspector or Thanedar. And he has been killed. And yet the police action is so lax, so lackadaisical, so delayed.
Yes,
I am of the view that obviously the environments in UP are so that they do not bother. They know that if something happens, we must go after the cow slaughter or cow carcass rather than the man having been slaughtered.
Right. Thank you, Mr. Singh. I want to take the question now to Anita Agarwal, who represents the Uttar Pradesh BJP. Anita ji, hamare saath jodne ke liye bahut dhanyawad. Aapne suna abhi Atul Chandra, jo bahut senior journalist hai, aur CP Singh, jo Punjab ke former inspector general of police hai, unka kehna hai ki Uttar Pradesh police ne ab tak 10 din ho gaye electronic surveillance karke, unhone key accused jo hai Yogesh Raj ko abhi tak giriftar nahi kiya. Iska matlab yehi hai ki Uttar Pradesh police ya Uttar Pradesh sarkar Yogesh Raj ko bacha rahi hai, chupa rahi hai. Kyun?
ऐसा बिल्कुल जी नहीं, ऐसा बिल्कुल नहीं है. हमारे यहाँ काफ़ी लोगों को उन्होंने अरेस्ट भी किया है, पकड़े भी गए हैं. सबसे बड़ी बात यह है कि एक बहुत बड़ी घटना होने से बचाया है पुलिस ने. ये एक साजिश तहत हुआ था, ये जो इसमें एक साजिश रची गई थी जिसमें कि ये पूरी उसकी कार्रवाई हो रही है कि वहाँ पे एक धर्म का वहाँ पे कार्यक्रम चल रहा था, उनको उसी रास्ते से जाना था. एक बहुत बड़ा इसमें कांड होते होते हमारी सरकार पुलिस ने बहुत सूझबूझ से काम किया, जो कि इस मॉब लिंचिंग को एक बड़ी दुर्घटना होने से रोक लिया गया. क्योंकि वहाँ पर पूरे पश्चिम में इसकी आग लगाना चाह रहे थे कि पश्चिम प्रदेश में पूरी आग लग जाए, लेकिन ये तो हमारी पुलिस की सूझबूझ है, हमारे लोगों की है कि सूझबूझ में रोका. और सबसे बड़ा ऐसा नहीं है कि पुलिस उसको बचाने का काम, पुलिस किसी को बचाने का काम नहीं कर रही, लेकिन ये साजिश तय किया गया है. जान के गौ मांस के टुकड़े हिंदू परिवार के घरों के सामने फेंके गए हैं. और जिससे
तो मुझे एक बात बताइए अनीता जी, आप कह रहे हैं कि पुलिस के होशियारी से
दूसरे धर्म का कार्य,
आप कह रहे हैं पुलिस के होशियारी से बहुत बड़ा हादसा रोका गया था, बचाया था. कौन सी पुलिस, किस पुलिस अफसर की होशियारी से ये हो गया था, आप मुझे बता सकते हैं? सुबोध कुमार सिंह ने बचाया था पूरी दक्षिण उत्तर प्रदेश को, उनको उनके उनके हत्या पे आपने अभी भी उनके मेन अक्यूज्ड को अरेस्ट नहीं किया है.
ये शहीद हुए हैं ये इंस्पेक्टर.
हाँ तो मारने वाले को कौन अक्यूज करेगा, कौन कौन गिरफ्तार करेगा, आप मुझे बताइए कितना टाइम लगेगा?
नहीं, देखिए पुलिस ही गिरफ्तार करेगी, कई लोगों को अरेस्ट कर चुकी है, जहां जाके उनके मिल रहा है, सारी सूझबूझ सारा हो रहा है. ऐसा नहीं कि लोगों को गिरफ्तार नहीं किया गया, पकड़ा नहीं गया या उनकी कार्रवाई नहीं हो रही. जांच भी हो रही है, कार्रवाई भी हो रही है, लेकिन आप जो चीज़ एक सही है उसको सामने अगर लाया जाए कि कितनी कितना अच्छी तरीके से उन्होंने वहाँ पर उसको बचाया, इतने बड़े कांड होने से बचाया. क्योंकि आप खुद सोचिए कि ये करे हिंदू परिवार के घर के आगे.
नहीं, आप एक बात, एक मिनट, ये हिंदू मुसलमान वाली बात आप मत कहिए, हमें नहीं सुनना है. मुझे बस यही सुनना है कि आपने एक अपने FIR में,
हम नहीं कह रहे
87 पीपल की नाम लिखा है आपने FIR में. अरेस्ट हुए, गिरफ्तार हुए अब तक 14. उसमें मेन अक्यूज जो है योगेश राज की गिरफ्तारी नहीं हुई. योगेश राज कहाँ है, आप मुझे ये बताइए. अनीता अग्रवाल जी, क्या उत्तर प्रदेश पुलिस ने इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्वेलेंस यूज करके योगेश राज की वो जो वीडियो उन्होंने रिलीज किया था, उस वीडियो का आपने इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्वेलेंस किया है, क्या आप जानते हो?
देखिए योगेश राज की बात है, वो भी कहता है इसमें जो मेन एक्सक्यूट थे वो इस जिले से बाहर वाले दो लोग भी थे, उनको भी पकड़ा जा रहा है. 27 लोग कब तक उसमें पकड़ लिए जा चुके. ऐसा नहीं है कि पुलिस उसमें हाथ पे हाथ धरे बैठी, पुलिस इसका पूरी कार्रवाई कर रही है. और योगेश राज भी बहुत जल्दी आपके सामने पकड़े जाएंगे, ऐसा नहीं, अगर वो मुलजिम है तो अवश्य पकड़े जाएंगे.
आप क्यों कह रहे हो कि अगर वो मुलजिम, आपको कोई डाउट है? आपने कहा अगर वो मुर्जिम है वो पकड़े जाएंगे, आपको कोई डाउट है कि वो मुर्जिम?
डाउट क्या, हमने कहा ना बिल्कुल, जो नहीं, जो मुलजिम है वो अवश्य पकड़ा जाएगा. क्योंकि मॉब लिंची का मामला भीड़ का मामला है, कोई ऐसा नहीं कि एक दो व्यक्ति का हाथ का मामला है. और वहां पे 27 लोग पकड़े जा चुके हैं ऑलरेडी.
सीनियर अफसर की मर्डर का मामला है मैडम, दिस इज द मोस्ट सीरियस मैटर फॉर योर पुलिस फोर्स.
मर्डर का मामला है, हम मान रहे हैं, क्योंकि ये जो बिल्कुल बिल्कुल सीरियस मैटर है, सीरियस लिया जा रहा है। पुलिस ने उसको बड़ी सूझबूझ से बचाया है उस कांड को होने से। ये हम ना हम हिंदू मुस्लिम की बात कर रहे हैं, हम बल्कि वहाँ की मॉब लिंचिंग की बात कर रहे हैं। मॉब लिंचिंग भीड़ को जल्दी से रोक पाना हर उसमें कठिन होता है।
लेकिन आपने अगर अगर आप कह रहे हैं कि साजिश रचाया गया, तो आपने अगर आप कह रहे हैं कि साजिश थी, अगर आप कह रहे हैं कि षड्यंत्र हुआ वहां पे, तो आपने अभी तक की अक्यूज को अरेस्ट क्यों नहीं किया है? क्या आप जानते हो कि योगेश राज कौन से ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के रीजनल हेड थे? योगेश राज बजरंग दल के सदस्य थे, उन बजरंग दल के कार्यकर्ता थे, कि आप जानते हो?
देखिए चाहे वो आप चाहे वो बजरंग दल के हो, चाहे वो भाजपा के हो, चाहे किसी को जो भी एक्यूज होगा उसको बख्शा नहीं जाएगा, ये मान लीजिए योगी सरकार में, वो चाहे भारतीय जनता पार्टी का ही क्यों ना हो।
Well, let me bring in the rest of my panel. Mr. K.K. Manan joins us right now, senior criminal lawyer out of Delhi. Mr. Manan, aapne abhi sunha Anita ji ne kya kaha. Are you happy with these answers, Mr. Manan?
I'm not satisfied at all, because even otherwise she is performing her duty. She will not accept it. If she will accept it, then her job will go. She will not be a spokesman if she is a spokesman of the party, because she has to defend her party. This way or that way, she cannot accept your plea. If she will accept your plea, meaning by, she is accepting the story of the anchor. So, anyway, now the question is whether, if you remember, on the last two show, I am requesting you, I am telling on the national television, this Mr. Yogi doesn't have any administrative experience at all. He can give speeches. He has given speeches in Telangana. One member, that assembly member, whatever MLA came, where he has given so much, I mean, the hatred speech that against one particular man who was sitting MLA, and he was Mohammedan. I don't want to name him, that he will take him from his house and take away from this country. He cannot stay there. All these things, hatred speeches, will not work now. You have seen the result of three states. People are not concerned with anything. People are concerned with the progress, law and order. People want, earlier these people were telling, in Akhilesh Yadav's regime, it's a laugh jungle. Hmm. But laugh jungle in three, four incidents. Lucknow incident, you have seen that. What is the reaction? Painful thing is, in this incident, even this Honorable Chief Minister even did not utter even a word regarding this sub-inspector's death. And even his family met him at his residence. Not he came to the spot or to meet the family members to console them. No, he did not. Rather, he was enjoying the kabaddi in somewhere else or some other functions. After coming from Andhra Pradesh or Uttar or Rajasthan, it is what we can say. You see that when you are handing over a big state of 80 MPs, a very big state of the country, to a person who is not well conversant, you will put the map of the UP before him, he will not be able to identify few places even. Anyway, it may be a derogatory, but it is the truth. It's maybe my perception, but the question is when he will say that yes, 2 + 2 = 4. Still he is telling 9. He was talking about cow slaughter. He was talking about that few meat pieces were lying there. Now my another panelist, BJP spokesman, person, she was telling that few meat, cow meat was just was in front of the houses. Hmm. But the question is, who has done it? You have, if you remember it, two names of innocent children were given in that FIR. Five people were not residing in the village. Even. So they have named those people. They have not done any homework before lodging the report. The report of this cow incident was lodged immediately by the police instead of own sub-inspector.
Yes.
Daylight murder, his report was not lodged by them. What does it mean? Meaning by that higher authorities were supervising this whole incident under the guidance of the chief minister, under the guidance of somebody else.
Why should we hesitate to say all these things?
We are citizens. I don't belong to any party.
Yes.
But the
Mr. Manan, let me. I have two more guests to bring in, and Abdul Hafiz Gandhi of the Samajwadi Party. Abdul Hafiz Gandhi, if you could just tell us, Uttar Pradesh obviously has not been a jungle raj for this one government. Aapki jab government ki chal rahi thi Samajwadi Party, tabhi bhi jungle raj thi, abhi bhi jungle raj hai. Uttar Pradesh mein problem kya hai, Mr. Gandhi?
Faiz, the administration and the law and order under our government was much, much better than what is prevailing now. Now, what do you expect from a chief minister against whom criminal cases are pending? And the government is not giving permission to pursue the criminal cases against the chief minister. Mr. Chief Minister is the most polarizing figure in India at present right now. He's the most incompetent chief minister. He knows only how to polarize and divide people. Now, the very first statement which came from the chief minister after holding the review meeting after the Bulandshahr incident, and he in that press release, he didn't utter a single word in sympathy for the deceased police officer. What he said, that action must be taken against the alleged cow slaughterers. So his priority was very clear that he wanted action against the alleged cow slaughterer, not against the hooligans, not against the gunda elements who perpetrated the violence in Bulandshahr.
Well, one second. You know, let me just point out to you, Mr. Abdul Hafiz Gandhi. It's very easy to point fingers at another government, Mr. Gandhi. But do you want to deny the fact that 54% of Akhilesh Yadav's cabinet when he was chief minister of Uttar Pradesh had criminal cases pending against them? The CBI has some heat on Akhilesh Yadav over the Jawahar Bagh case. So this is an old tradition in Uttar Pradesh to have politicians with cases against them. What is different now? Tell me.
Why, if you look the list, the 2017 list of VGP candidates, and I'm not saying it, ADR is saying it, 37% criminals were given ticket, and these criminals were not simple criminals, but hardened criminals were given ticket, and most of them won. So the criminalization of politics has been increased when VGP came in, and same is the case with the Lok Sabha. The VGP gave the highest number of tickets to criminals. So they cannot speak when it comes to criminals. My whole point is that the chief minister is a polarizing figure. He has given the message to the lower rung cadres that if you belong to a particular organization, if you belong to some affiliates of RSS or the VGP, nothing will happen to you. Nothing will come to you. And that is why the criminal Yogesh Raj, who is named at number one place in FIR, he is not being arrested. The second criminal, the Agarwal, he's not being arrested. You are arresting other people. You took the prompt action as far as the alleged cow slaughterers are concerned and the cow slaughter FIR is concerned. But you are not paying enough attention as far as this second FIR is concerned. So this shows the priority of the government. And I will say that this government will not arrest Yogesh Raj. This government will not arrest Agarwal because they want this polarization to continue for 2019. They are interested in polarizing.
Well, let me just point this out to you also. This is just data to rebut what you have just said, Mr. Gandhi. First of all, 28 ministers out of the 56 in the Akhilesh government had criminal cases pending against them, 11 of them, very serious charges like murder, attempt to murder, kidnapping, according to the ADR. That's one thing. Second thing, Mr. Gandhi, my name is Faye D'Souza. Fur pe ek matra dalke Faye. Now, Ramakant Gore, is there a reason why someone accused of such a serious matter like shooting a police officer cannot be found in 10 days? Is the UP police incapable of doing it?
It is something I disagree with that, Faye. UP police is competent enough to nail down the terrorist, what to talk of these two criminals who are just naive. But as a matter of fact, I would admire, before I start my statement, I would admire the statement of the BJP spokesperson, who said ye ek saajish thi. She is admitting that on national television, and she is referring to Director General of Police's statement today. So DG Police OP Singh has made this statement. Secondly, she said that there was an apprehension of communal violence and police tried to stave that off. So there are two admittances on her part. A, there was a conspiracy which is beyond the murder. Second, there was an apprehension of communal violence. Now, she is actually taking a different line what her chief minister said, that this is an accident. Now, we need to look at the incidents. A retrospective aspect may be looked into. Some 48 hours old carcasses were planted. Some people, and those some people were related to Bajrang Dal and BJP, created and caused unlawful assembly, purely in legalistic terms, blocked the road, damaged the property of police station, killed a police inspector in presence of SDM and other police officials. So police was incompetent when they were seeing a colleague being murdered. The police was armed. There was enough arm and ammunition in the police station. No action was taken. And whose behalf? We need to look at that. We cannot leave them, because senior police officials were also there. CO level officer was there. SP was there. What were they doing there? If they could not save their own colleague, what will they do in front of that mob which is relating to the ruling party? They could not charge the ruling party unlawful assembly. That was the first instance where they should have swung into action. But they did not do that. Post that, the investigation was being conducted into carcasses and not cow slaughter, and which was emphasized by the police and by the chief minister. So if the chief minister is saying something, can an investigating officer got the courage to go in different lines? The answer is emphatic no. Chief minister is saying this is an accident. We need to look at the cow slaughter cases. We will also look into inspector's murder. Nothing had happened. The sections which were invoked against the people who were from unlawful assembly. They were the sections of Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, which clearly can assail the organization which is organizing such kind of unlawful assembly, damaging the police station, killing an inspector. No action is taken against that organization. Now, whosoever was that is not being booked. So whosoever is being booked are the criminals who are named or who are simple workers.
Well, let me point this out, Ramakant, and now I want to open this up to the panel.
Somebody who is the main accused.
Yes, has not been arrested. And this is for also the benefit of Anita Agarwal, who keeps saying that Sadish hum judge kar rahe. Let me tell you how well your police is investigating this, Sadish. Apart from the probe into the violence, Uttar Pradesh filed an FIR. The police filed an FIR into cow slaughter, and on the basis of that complaint, specifically written by Bajrang Dal leader Yogesh Raj, who's key accused in the case, the two suspects named were 11 and 12 years old. In fact, a week ago, our reporter Priyank Tripathi spoke to those two children and their father. Take a look at it. Look at the investigation of the Uttar Pradesh police.
Aaj police wale aapko leke aaye the?
Yes.
अच्छा क्या हुआ बताइए
हुआ तो कुछ नहीं बस पूछा था नाम वगैरह घर पता बता दिया मैंने सब और कुछ नहीं पूछा
आपको भी ले गए थे
हाँ यस
हाँ क्या हुआ था
कुछ भी नहीं पूछा था बस ये पूछा था नाम वगैरह और पता बस
आपको पता चला आप लोगों क्यों लेके गए थे पुलिस वाले
नहीं
नहीं पता आपको
नहीं
लेट्स टॉक टू हिज फादर आपको लगता है योगेश ने गलत नाम दिए या पुलिस ने गलत लोगों को सवाल जवाब के बजाय बच्चों को थाने ले जाना नॉर्मल सेंस बताता है कि इतने छोटे बच्चे अगर गौकशी करना भी चाहें तो नहीं कर सकते?
ये तो कुछ भी नहीं कर सकते, गौकशी क्या, ये इनसे अभी कह लेंगे कि बेटे चूहा मार दो, उसको भी भगेंगे डर के। तो बताओ ये गौकशी करने लायक हैं? आप भी जानते हो और भी जानते हैं, अब इन बच्चों के ऊपर जो भी लगाया है गलत आरोप लग रहा है जो भी है।
अनीता जी वाह, बहुत बहुत कड़क तहकीकात हो रही है आपकी उत्तर प्रदेश में, बच्चों को लेके जा रहे हैं आप थाने?
देखिए जी नहीं, बिल्कुल नहीं, ऐसा नहीं है, बच्चों को लेके जा रहे हैं थाने, जिसपे जो जो FIR हुई है, जिस हिसाब से नाम आए हैं उस हिसाब से, बाकी ऐसा नहीं है कि हम लोग किसी को छोड़ दे, चाहे वो कोई हो, ना हम हिंदू देखेंगे ना मुसलमान, जिसने गलत किया उस पर सजा होगी। मैंने अभी आपसे कहा है, चाहे वो बजरंग दल का हो, चाहे वो भारतीय जनता पार्टी का हो, चाहे किसी भी दल का हो, कोई बख्शा नहीं जाएगा। और अभी हमारे समाजवादी प्रवक्ता बता रहे थे कि यहाँ पे बहुत ज्यादा, इनके समय में मुजफ्फरनगर कांड शायद इनको याद नहीं है, मुजफ्फरनगर कांड में वहां से पलायन हुआ था लोगों का, इनको कितना बड़े दंगे हुए थे, इनके उसमें किसी को पे कार्रवाई नहीं हुई थी।
आप जो और मैंने सवाल पूछा आप उसके बारे में जवाब दे दीजिए, क्या आप जानते हैं अनीता जी, क्या आप जानते हैं कि किसी भी केस में बच्चों को आप ऐसे उठा के थाने लेके नहीं जा सकते?
देंगे लेकिन नहीं, बच्चों को उठाकर बच्चों से जानकारी लेने के लिए, क्योंकि बच्चे लोग हैं जो सामने देखे भी हैं कि क्या हुआ क्या नहीं हुआ, बच्चों को काफी जानकारी होती है जब एक मॉब लिंचिंग का होता है
तो आपने ऑब्वियसली पुलिस SOP पढ़ा नहीं है, क्योंकि बच्चों को आप ऐसे थाने लेके नहीं जा सकते। हमारे कानून होते हैं बच्चों के बारे में, कानून होते हैं हमारे देश में, पुलिस ऐसे उनके घर आके उनको थाना लेके नहीं जा सकते।
लेकिन बच्चों,
तो आप मुझे ये बताइए, बच्चों को तो आपने आप लेके गए, बच्चों को आपने ढूंढ लिया, योगेश राज अभी तक नहीं ढूंढा आपने, क्यों?
बच्चों से ऐसा नहीं है, उसको नहीं ढूंढ रहे हैं, ढूंढ रहे हैं उसको भी,
ढूंढ रहे
हैं, हमने अब से कहा 27 लोग हम लोग अभी तक पकड़ चुके हैं, और हमारे
27 मैंने आपने 4 तो गौ हत्या के लिए पकड़ा
के लोग भी थे, ऐसा नहीं खाली उसे जिले।
वन सेकेंड, Let me explain this to you, Ramakant Gaur, if you could explain in Hindi, please, what are the laws in this country about, what are the laws in this country, Ramakant Gaur, aap Hindi mein bata dijiye, about picking up children and taking them to the police station like this?
Ms. Agarwal, dekhi, Bharat mein ek pustak hai samvidhan, jiske tahat ye desh chalta hai. आप, आपके प्रधानमंत्री, मुख्यमंत्री, मैं या कोई भी नागरिक, सामान्य नागरिक हो या विशिष्ट नागरिक हो, संविधान के तहत ही कार्य करेगा। और इस देश का संविधान कानूनों को जन्म देता है, और इस देश के वो कानून ये बड़े क्लियरली बात कहते हैं कि एक महिला होगी तो उसको सांझ ढले नहीं ले जा सकते, और बच्चे होंगे तो उनसे इन्वेस्टिगेशन करने का एक तरीका है, तहकीकात करने का तरीका है, वो तरीका इस पर्टिकुलर केस में अगर उन्हें थाने ले जाया गया और उन्हें इस तरीके से बात की गई तो वो वायलेट हुआ है। तो आपको ये समझना होगा कि आप असंवेदनशील हो जाएंगी अगर बच्चों के से जांच के विषय में, तो मुझे लगेगा यह विषय अपने आप में दुखद होगा। बच्चों से जांच प्रक्रिया जारी की गई और इस तरीके से, अवैध तरीके से उन्हें थाने ले जाया गया,
जी नहीं,
ये गलत है, ये गलत है, असंवैधानिक है,
ऐसा नहीं है।
और आपको पता नहीं, अगर आपको तथ्यों का पता नहीं है, अगर आपको तथ्यों का पता है, अगर आप तथ्यों का पता है तो बता दीजिए ना योगेश राज के।
आप शांत हो जाइए अनीता जी, आप सुन लीजिए, ये बड़े बड़े वकील हैं, उनको मालूम है, कानून मालूम है। के मानन जी बताएंगे, मिस्टर मानन आप प्लीज हिंदी में बता दीजिए, क्या ये अलाउड है ऐसे बच्चों को उठा के थाना लेके जाना?
अरे अब्दुल मनान जी को भी अच्छे से मालूम है कि हम भी इस कानून को जानते हैं,
जिस तरह से रामकांत गौर जी ने बताया है,
अनीता जी आप सुन तो लीजिए,
पूछताछ करना,
अनीता जी आप सुन लीजिए, आप सुन नहीं रहे हो, आप सुन लीजिए,
क्या बात करती हैं आप, बच्चों को ले जा सकते हैं पुलिस स्टेशन कोई?
अब सुन लीजिए, के मानन जी बताएंगे, मिस्टर मानन प्लीज बताइए,
अरेस्ट कर सकते हैं उनको?
अरेस्ट नहीं किया बच्चों को,
उनको अरेस्ट भी नहीं कर सकते, अरेस्ट
नहीं, हमने कहा अरेस्ट नहीं किया
मैडम, जुवेनाइल कोर्ट होती है, जुवेनाइल जस्टिस एक्ट है,
अरेस्ट उनसे केवल पूछताछ की। आई हम जानते हैं, आप भी अच्छे से जानते हैं कि हम भी जानते हैं, लेकिन सबसे बड़ी बात की
बात करनी, क्या जवाब दें जब
अरेस्ट नहीं किया, उनसे पूछताछ की।
आपको रमाकांत गौर जी ने कितने सहज तरीके से, कितने सरल तरीके से समझाया,
देखिए उन्होंने बच्चों से केवल
मैडम आपको रमाकांत गौड़ जी ने कितने सरल तरीके से समझाया है, आप समझने की कोशिश करो, आप समझने की कोशिश नहीं कर रही हैं। उनको नहीं थाने ले जा सकते थे, एक जुवेनाइल को नहीं इस तरह थाने ले जा सकते थे, ये देश का कानून है। उनके घर में अगर उनकी माता पिता के सामने को पूछताछ करते तो बात अलग थी।
In fact, let me get a third person in. एक मिनट।
जब आपका बच्चा कभी किसी दिन लेके जाएगी ना कोई सरकार, कोई पुलिस, फिर पता लगेगा आपको।
एक मिनट।
आप फिर बात
मुझे, वो मुझे, मुझे मिस्टर सिंह से भी पूछना है। एक मिनट।
वो दूसरे वकील साहब ने समझाया, मैं आपको समझा रहा हूँ कि पुलिस उनको पूछताछ कर सकती है, लेकिन उनके माता पिता के समक्ष उनकी उपस्थिति में अगर बाई नेम FIR है उनके घर पर, अगर वो इस बात से सेटिस्फाई है कि बच्चे इस क्राइम में इन्वॉल्व हैं, तो उनको जुवेनाइल एक्ट के तहत अरेस्ट भी कर सकते हैं, लेकिन इस तरह नहीं जिस तरह आप कह रही हैं। ये गलत तरीका है, ये लॉ नहीं है, इस देश का कानून नहीं है ये। आप दो दूनी नौ कहना बंद कर दो, कानून का नहीं पता, सीधा कहो कि मुझे इस बात की से मैं
आपकी बात समझ गए।
इस बात का मुझे नहीं पता।
तीसरे एक्सपर्ट को मैं लेके आऊंगी।
समझ गए?
एक मिनट। अनीता जी आप शांत हो जाइए।
आपने बच्चों का बयान सुना? आपने बच्चों का बयान सुना? उन्होंने क्या कहा है कि पुलिस ने हमें कुछ नहीं कहा, खाली पूछा कि तुमने देखा है, हमने कहा नहीं, उन्होंने
मैडम आप आधे घंटे के लिए अभी अपने आप को कर दो, आपसे मैं लाल
बच्चों से डिसाइड करवा देंगे आप जी। बहुत अच्छी बात है मिस्टर सिंह, दो चीजें हैं मिस्टर सिंह यहाँ पे, एक बच्चों को, यस मिस्टर सिंह लेट मी आस्क द क्वेश्चन प्लीज। पॉइंट नंबर वन, 11 ईयर ओल्ड एंड अ 12 ईयर ओल्ड वर नेम्ड इन द FIR एंड द पुलिस केम एंड पिक्ड देम अप एंड टुक देम टू द पुलिस स्टेशन, ब्रॉट देम बैक, दैट्स पॉइंट नंबर टू। द FIR वाज रिटन बेस्ड ऑन द रिक्वेस्ट ऑफ योगेश राज, हु इज द की अक्यूज्ड। योगेश राज, मेंबर ऑफ बजरंग दल, 10 डेज डाउन, हैज स्टिल नॉट बीन फाउंड। इफ वी पुट दीज थ्री फैक्ट्स टुगेदर मिस्टर सिंह, how would you rate like the investigation that is going on right now? Mr. Singh, aap bataiye.
I'd like to. Initially, I told you the investigation right from the start is absolutely dismal because of the reason that they were being inspired from outside. They were being guided from outside. Because when you say it's accidental, some police officers say it's a conspiracy. And conspiracy hogi. That is a different, it's a question of murder. First you pay attention to the murder. You are going to the conspiracy. She should be told, the BJP spokesperson, for conspiracy they have to so many people together, a common intention, this, that. This is a long drawn out process to prove conspiracy. You have put the direction of the investigation differently. They started investigation into the conspiracy. Then somebody says, he says, no, it is an accidental. No, what the police officer thinks? He says, all right, the senior officers are saying, let me go to that direction. The question is, as you asked for the investigation right from the start. Then you are not able, CCTV has now shown them that this service revolver has been used. Why the CCTV cameras were not seen earlier for the last 10 days or 8 days? Now all of a sudden we have seen the CCTV when the media has woken up, the media has shaken them up. Now investigation, I think, has not been done on the correct line. Number two, as far as the young children having been taken to police station, man, the very fact when you call a person or you take even very senior person, senior citizen or elder or jawan, usko bhi agar aap le jate hain, wo dhakhauf khata hai. Aaj police ka image hai, aur police station mein le ja rahe hain. Immediately, there's a mental pressure on the child. Why he is being taken to the police station? You have created a mental pressure by taking him to the police station. If it's all you wanted something, we have done so many investigations in Punjab. There is a rule of law. Rule of law says, all right, you go to the child. You sit down with him. You sit down with him in his house. Then ask him questions, whatever you feel like. And if you find it's all right, there also, house. You are sitting with them so that the people know there is no question being caused. It's a coercive method. You bring him to the police station. The very fact you are bringing him to the police station is a coercive method. Third, who is named them? The person who is himself accused of a murder. The inquiry is being conducted on the basis of FIR lodged by a person who is himself accused of murder. And on the basis of that, that FIR is much more important for us rather than the FIR of murder to be taken into consideration. So in this case also, I feel this is absolutely improper. Fourth, the environments which have been created in the state, the venomous environment, every now and then there is some statement, venomous statement. And every now and then we are looking at, absolutely we are closing our eyes, clapping people who have done this thing. Wherever somebody comes after creating some problem of cow slaughter, etc., he is garlanded, he is greeted, he is said shabash. Naturally, the atmosphere in the state has become so much that everyone thinks they should take law into their heart because we are supporting this cow slaughter case. Oh, we'll do it. This is not the way. This is absolutely violation, and I will tell you, this is a flagrant violation of actual law and order. This is not like actual order. First, we always say investigation about murder. Now, the second part, as my one of my friends has said, they are cases of mob violence. Mob violence, who are the people? The entire, you have named 40, 50 people who were included.
87.
But mob violence, who was creating that mob violence? Who was instigating people? That is the person who is Yogesh Yadav and his group. Because they immediately went first, they lodged the report.
Yes, yes.
That means their intention was that they lodged the FIR about the cow slaughter. And now there's a violence. And that violence has been created. You are not looking at the people who are behind creating that violence. You are looking at the people who were part of that, which also will not be proved because there are only, and if it is proved, it is very, very minor offenses. The people have done some hooliganism. 27 people have been arrested. How many people out of that they have arrested who were responsible for organizing this violence? My submission is that all along, the police investigation, the way of investigating, and ultimately taking into the police station the young children, it shows what is happening in the state. It's a complete state of sort of, you know, lawlessness. Lawlessness according to our terms, but according to the terms of this particular government, it is a very lawful government. Because
yes.
Any person...
In fact, Mr. Singh, let me bring in a couple of people on the phone line right now, if I may.
So this is their law.
Yes. Captain Jaspal is on the phone line from Rohtak in Haryana. Captain Jaspal, go ahead, please.
Good evening, Faye.
Good evening.
Systematically and procedurally, number one, the inquiry should have been by a sitting judge of the High Court or a retired Supreme Court judge of a proven integrity. The people who deserted this SHO, policemen, they should have been charged with desertion. All senior officers in the chain of command, they should have been suspended. And what was SHO doing? He was representing the Home Minister, Chief Minister and DGP. He is lynched, and these people are not shaken and moved. They are waiting to be lynched in Lucknow. Is this the culture they want? And why they are doing so? Because they have downloaded the same app that UPA was doing. Have a figurehead, run him by a remote control, parrot throughout the day that is very honest. It is the most corrupt and disgraceful government. It has no reason yes. to be in power.
Okay, let me ask one more question. Yes, yes, yes. Let me ask one more question of Anita Agarwal. Anita ji, ek aur sawal hai aapse, agar main pooch sakti hu. Jo is case ke dusre accused, main accused hai, Shikhar Agarwal. Shikhar Agarwal ne ek video release kiya tha, jisme unhone kaha tha ki Subodh Kumar Singh ne गाय हत्या की के लिए एफआईआर दर्ज नहीं किया था इसलिए उनको मारा गया था आपको याद है ये वीडियो वीडियो का ये थोड़ा ही विजुअल्स हमारे चैनल पे चल रहे हैं अभी
नहीं
शिखर अग्रवाल अभी कहां है
नहीं नहीं ये वीडियो हमने देखा था शिखर अग्रवाल ने अपना पूरा बयान बताया था
ये भाजपा की यूथ विंग प्रेसिडेंट है शिखर अग्रवाल
ऐसा पुलिस ने उसके बयान पूरे लिए हैं
नहीं नहीं शिखर अग्रवाल भाजपा के कार्यकर्ता है
देखिए बिल्कुल नहीं है उन्होंने पूरी जान देखिए वो कार्यकर्ता है कि नहीं मुझे जानकारी नहीं है लेकिन सबसे बात है उन्होंने पूरे बयान दिए हैं उन्होंने बताया है किस तरह से कैसे कार्य हुआ है और सबसे बड़ी बात है कि इसमें पुख्ता पूरी एक ये पूरे एक व्यक्ति का काम नहीं है दो व्यक्ति का काम नहीं है पूरी मॉब लिंचिंग हुई है पूरे उसमें कई लोग
अनीता जी अगर आप कह रहे हैं कि शिखर अग्रवाल ने पुलिस को अपने बयान दिया है तो क्या शिखर अग्रवाल अभी कस्टडी में है उनको गिरफ्तार किया गया है पुलिस ने
नहीं पुलिस बिल्कुल पुलिस पुलिस की कार्रवाई में है वो, उन्होंने जब वो उसमें पूरी उनका इन्वॉल्वमेंट उसमें नहीं है, वो उसमें पूरी तरह से उन्होंने पूरी एक एक चीज की जानकारी दी जो वहां पे हुआ है, और वो जानकारी सबसे ले रहे हैं, पुलिस सबसे जानकारी
एक मिनट
आप से फिर बता
जी, आप एक मिनट आप सवाल सुन लीजिए, मैं सवाल फिर से पूछती हूं,
जो मेन एक्सक्यूज होगा
अक्यूज्ड होगा जी, नहीं नहीं अब सवाल सुन लीजिए, शिखर अग्रवाल
पकड़ा जाएगा,
मेन अक्यूज्ड है योगेश राज के साथ, उनका नाम एफआईआर में दर्ज किया गया मेन अक्यूज्ड करके, और उनके खिलाफ अभी यूपी पुलिस ने नॉन अवेलेबल वारंट इश्यू किया है, और आप कह रहे हैं कि उनका कोई हाथ नहीं है इस मर्डर में, आप कैसे कह सकते हो, आप जज हो, आप मैजिस्ट्रेट हो?
नहीं नहीं हमने हमने कहा उन्होंने उन्होंने नहीं नहीं देखिए उन्होंने पूरे बयान दिए हैं, पूरे हर तरह से बताया है, और सबसे बड़ी बात मैंने आपसे कहा जो भी उसको
पकड़ा उन्होंने पूरा बयान दिया है पुलिस को,
मैंने फिर
कब दिया उन्होंने पुलिस को बयान, बयान कब दिया था उन्हें उन्होंने पुलिस को?
अरे जब सब हत्या वहाँ पे जो पूछताछ चल रही थी उस समय उनकी पूरी एक वीडियो वायरल हुई थी जो हमने देखी थी।
अच्छा तो आप वीडियो को मान रहे हैं बयान, आप वीडियो, अच्छा आप वीडियो, आप वीडियो को सच मान रहे हैं, आप वीडियो में जो बताया गया सारे बातें आप सच मान रहे हो?
जो नहीं वीडियो को सच नहीं, वीडियो को सच नहीं मान रहे, जो वायरल हुआ जो आप भी तो वायरल ही बता रहे हैं, हम भी वीडियो वायरल ही बता रहे हैं, लेकिन सबसे बड़ी बात यह है कि हमने आपसे कहा कि मॉब लिंचिंग में जिस तरह की एफआईआर हुई है या जो लोग इन्वॉल्वमेंट होंगे उनको बख्शा नहीं जाएगा, वो पकड़े जाएंगे।
बख्शा तो जा रहे हैं अनीता जी, बजरंग दल के कार्यकर्ता और भाजपा के कार्यकर्ता को बचाया जा रहा है, बख्शा जा रहा है, इसलिए इस बात को हम इस बात को
बिल्कुल नहीं, अगर आपको शायद मालूम आपको शायद मालूम है लखनऊ के अंदर एक भाजपा कार्यकर्ता कहीं भी गोलीकांड से मारा गया है, आपको शायद अच्छी तरह से मालूम होगा लखनऊ के अंदर भी बीजेपी कार्यकर्ता को क्या बताया गया,
फिर आप बताइए ये
योगी
अनीता जी ने तो इनका जो वीडियो वायरल वीडियो है उनको सच मान लिया है, उनको बयान मान लिया, उन्होंने मान लिया कि ये निर्दोष है,
बीजेपी कार्यकर्ता है
नहीं, सच नहीं मान लिया, सच नहीं मान लिया, लेकिन आप भी वीडियो वायरल की बात,
अनीता जी ने ये कहा कि ये बयान पुलिस के सामने
आपने भी वीडियो वायरल, आपने वीडियो वायरल की चक्कर में हम भी वीडियो वायरल का चक्कर कर रहे हैं,
पूछा
आई हैव टू आल्सो आस्क अ क्वेश्चन ऑफ अतुल
चंद्रा, अनीता जी मैं आपकी एक और बात की प्रशंसा करना चाहूंगा,
एक मिनट मुझे एक सवाल अतुल जी से भी पूछना
है,
अनीता जी की प्रशंसा करना चाहूंगा, उन्होंने कहा मॉब लिंचिंग है,
वीडियो वायरल
इनके चीफ मिनिस्टर कहते हैं मॉब लिंचिंग नहीं है।
नहीं, I just want to bring one question before Atul Chandra. Atul Chandra, the government keeps talking about mob lynching. Anita ji keeps talking about mob lynching. But this was a case where a police officer was specifically targeted, where he was first hit in the head and then shot at close range from what we understand, because it was above his left eyebrow. All of the other policemen who were with him, 25 others, 15 of whom were armed, ran away and abandoned him while he was hurt. They've apparently been transferred for dereliction of duty. And now we understand that the two main accused have not been found. There is this long drawn-out process of a non-bearable warrant which is issued and which is just a way to show that the police is doing something without actually doing anything. What is your response to all of the answers you've heard Anita Agarwal of the BJP give us today?
Absolutely. See, first of all, the two boys who were picked up for cow slaughter were picked up only after the chief minister gave primacy to the killing of the cow over the killing of the inspector. That is one thing. Which means that the police acted at the behest, almost at the behest of the chief minister. The other thing is that Subodh Kumar Singh was being tracked by these Bajrang Dal activists from Akhlaq's time, from the time he was investigating Akhlaq's case. They were upset. If you recall, there was also a video in which his wife, or rather an audio in which his wife was saying that a local MLA was complaining and asking this inspector to withdraw cases or release some of the Bajrang Dal activists he had arrested. The third thing is, there is now a concerted effort to malign this inspector. There is a poster in Bulandshahr which speaks of how he asked for 10 crore bribe to set free or leave alone a history cheater. And also, he is being accused of murder. Now, if you look at the videos of the violence, they are targeting Subodh Singh only, no other policeman. Isi ne mara hai, isi ne mara hai, and they shoot him. There is no mob, there are just 2-3 people rushing towards him in that particular video. So I don't see any reason why it should be attributed to a mob, and why not just to a couple of people who wanted to eliminate Subodh Kumar Singh because he was an obstacle in their nefarious activities.
Absolutely. We have to leave this here now because we've run out of time, and also the BJP spokesperson has left. But I just want to promise the gentlemen on the panel one thing. As you have given us your time, we will continue to pay very, very close attention to this case. We will not allow the powers in Uttar Pradesh to brush this under the carpet. We will not allow for the two people on your screen who are prime accused to get away, because we know for a fact that the police forces in our team are sharp enough, fast enough and capable enough to arrest these people if they truly were backed by political will. We owe it to the family of the slain police officer Subodh Kumar Singh to fight for justice on their behalf, to fight for justice on his behalf. While the Uttar Pradesh government is right now taking credit for the fact that a riot was averted on that day, they must realize that the person who put his life at risk to avert that riot was Subodh Kumar Singh, who is now dead as a result, and his murderers are not being arrested. We will continue to put pressure on the Uttar Pradesh government until justice is done. We will not forget. Thanks for watching.